I YouTube. I played Daniel on Tuesday again. Not again, meaning not to quick chat. And he played d4. I played knight f6, and he played a London, because, you know, I guess he's afraid of my prep. Which I don't have any, so I don't know why you would be afraid of it. g6, knight c3, so he's playing a Jobava London, like, you know, everybody does now. And I falsely remembered that c5 was what I should play here, but I guess it's just a bad Benoni, but I just, for some reason, I just remembered getting a Benoni structure against the Jobava. I don't know where I got that. I guess I hallucinated it. But then he did not take advantage of c5, he just played e3, which is not a challenging move. I decided to take on d4 because I'm just trading a side pawn for a center pawn, which is, I don't know, opening principle. Developed a piece, he developed a piece, I castled, and he developed a piece. And then I was having trouble deciding between d6 or d5, and I decided to play d6 just because, I don't know, I felt like playing d5, like, yeah, I'm grabbing space, like, in the center, but I don't know, I felt like d6 was making this bishop look kind of stupid, so that's what I decided on. And I thought that if I ever go knight c6 and he pushes, I thought I would reroute my knight to c5 and that would be good for me. And if he ever pushes, it makes my bishop better. So that was my thinking behind d6, but apparently d5 is just a better move. I'll have to examine this further. But for now, d6 is a fine move. There, you know, there's not too big of a difference between the two. Okay, so he castles, and I play knight c6. And he actually ended up playing d5. And I kind of misevaluated this whole situation and what was going on here. So what would you do here as black? Because there is a good move here, and then there's what I did. So you already know what I did. I don't think it's that bad what I did. I mean, the computer dislikes it just because of the space advantage that white has. But I don't hate my position. Knight b8 to d7. Well, how is that different than doing this? Knight h5? I don't know about knight h5. Let's see. I guess I'll just move the bishop or something. And then my knight is on h5. Maybe he goes back to bishop e3 or something. Well, I hated it. That's right. I don't think taking on a6 is good for white, because, okay, he opened up my bishop with this d5 move, and then he's gonna give me an open file too to attack. Yeah, I have doubled pawns, but right now there's no way to take advantage of it, and since there's so many pieces still on the board, I would say that it's favorable for me to have these two open files to attack on. But I don't know, I mean, I'm not very good at chess, so the move has not been suggested yet. It's not something that I considered at all, but I do like it. After, you know, you play through it a little bit to try and understand it. It's kind of cool. Okay, so the correct answer is not moving the knight and playing e5. And this is just sacking a pawn. So it takes, I take with bishop, and, you know, I'm sacking the d pawn, but very strong bishops and piece activity or something. And, you know, if he takes with the queen, that's probably not very good because I just go queen b6. I'm going to get a tempo on the queen, so he would take with bishop, rook e8, and then, I don't know, just say something. Say he plays, like, rook e1 or something. Could play bishop f5 or bishop g4. So maybe my queen's coming to b6. It's like I'm down a pawn, but very strong pieces, I guess. Put the rook on c8 and attack the pawn this way, maybe. So this is what I should have done, but I didn't see this, and even if I saw it, I don't think I would have evaluated it correctly. So I just went on with my plan, and I thought this was good for me. It's not bad, it's just, you know, the computer likes white because of the space advantage. So he plays a3, I play knight a6, and now my knight is set up to go to c5, possibly. But then he plays knight d4, and I thought for a long time. I thought for 10 minutes here, which was too long to think on move 11. For one, but I just was, like, getting really confused. So it kind of feels like the threat is to take on a6 now and play knight c6, maybe. So I spent a long time thinking about knight c5, and I honestly, it was on Tuesday, but somehow I don't even remember what I found so unappealing about, like, I don't really, maybe knight c5 is what I should do. I thought for 10 minutes, and I was like, okay, knight c5 does do what I need it to do, but maybe bishop, I ended up playing bishop d7, because it kind of gets, you know, takes care of that threat a little bit, and it makes space for my rook to go to c8, which is, like, I mean, if I kind of was getting my hopes up, and I wanted to sack on c3. I think there's something wrong with me, because ever since that game where I, you know, my opponent allowed a sack on c3 and I didn't do it because I, like, was doubting myself. Ever since then, I've just been, like, trying to force it. Like, I have to do it now. I don't care what the position is. I need to sack a rook on c3. Like, overcorrecting. But yeah, that's, like, my idea for the whole rest of the game now. And I'm just, you know, he just doesn't have to allow it. Is the thing, but okay, he plays h3, so it's just, you know, then shit. Then I play rook c8, this makes sense. I want to take here and take here, that would be lovely if I could do that. But, here, it doesn't really work anymore, because this is defended, so I'm like, okay, I sack in exchange, but I don't really get anything for it, so that would not be wise. Okay, then I fought for a long time again. And I played something completely unhinged. I will say that I think it's kind of telling the kind of moves I make in these positions where I have no space and I have no plan. I think it really gets to me and I just make just completely irrational decisions. Like, I don't think I can handle it. I can't handle just, like, having nothing. So I came up with, like, I don't know, it's not good. Rook c4. Yeah. I actually did play rook c4. I played rook c4 because, well, I mean, for one, maybe I'm threatening this, is my idea. But there is just, like, a simple way to defend this. He just played bishop e3. I was like, oh, that's true. Now why is my rook on c4? Just why? And then I played knight c7, and I still want to take on c3 and take on d5 if he lets me. But then he plays this move, which is very annoying, because, okay, now I can't retreat. My rook is running out of squares. This is no longer a good thing, because he just recaptures with the knight. I can't play rook h4, because my rook is gonna get trapped, like this. So, at this point, I'm like, alright, well, this is not good. I feel like I'm losing here. Maybe not losing, but definitely a lot worse, and I just couldn't come up with a move. Like, I just didn't know what to do. So I played knight b5, just, you know, making a square for my rook. But the problem is, now after b3, he's mobilizing his pawns, and now my bishop sucks. And, you know, he's made improvements of, like, every one of his pieces, and I have made the opposite of that. So, yeah, I thought for a little while here, and so you could put your bishop on d7 or a6. What would chat do? They're about the same, I guess, but I would say practically one is a mistake. This wasn't a Sicilian. Request a 10-move take back. That would be nice. So I played bishop a6 because I thought my only idea was playing b5 or something, but I mean, I could still play b5 if my bishop is here. I don't really know what I was thinking. I just, like, this felt like too much of a retreat. They're both retreats, but I guess this is, like, putting it on a square it's already been on. So, yeah, I don't know. It's just a garbage position. There's not a whole lot I can do. But, okay, he plays knight d4. And I'm trying to get something going. I'm trying to, you know, activate my pieces to get some sort of counterplay. This defended that threat, which is very annoying. You know, I can't really do this. That's definitely not worth it. He's gonna do that. So then he plays this move. I play knight e5. But now there's a big problem because I can't. F4 is unstoppable. I mean, it's just a terrible position. So in my head, I evaluated this position as I was losing, which I was, you know, that's correct. Daniel thought I was just, like, worse, I think. I don't know. Maybe I'll ask him. But yeah, I thought I was losing here, so I might as well try something. And boy, did I come up with something. So, okay. F4 is the threat, right? Let's show threat. Never mind. F4 is second best. So if I just play something like this, then I have to go back and, you know, I waste, like, 4 moves with my knight, my bishop. My pieces are all in each other's way. It's just miserable. Like, I don't know. Like, I felt like if he gets F4 in, then I can resign. Probably could resign right here. But instead, I decided to play, g5. Which, yeah, it's a bad move. But I just was making a square for my knight and temporarily defending this threat. And, you know, after he takes it, I played queen d7 just to, oh yeah, because knight f5 would have been bad. F4, h6 I throw in. And now at least I feel like his bishop is, like, maybe a little bit of a worse piece than it was before, I guess. And now if I'm playing for b5, yeah, I'm down material and my position is terrible. But I'm just trying to get, like, make it as complicated as possible. So yeah, now I play b5, which I think is a good try, but unfortunately, he plays this very annoying move. This move I saw, but after f5, I didn't realize how strong bishop h5 is. So, I mean, I don't... Okay, I can't really move the knight, so I defend it with the rook. I'm also, you know, keeping an eye on this square, I guess. And now the issue is... Well, there, you know, this is the threat, so I moved my king out of that. But then he took on g7, which I didn't see coming for some reason. And now that I don't have a pawn on f5, he has bishop g5. And, you know, I'll just speed through the rest of this because it's not that important. Yeah, I'd like to take with the bishop maybe, but then I didn't like the idea of letting him take here with the rook, so I took with the queen. And, yeah, this is just copium from here on out. Whoops. This is really brutal too, because I can't even, he's threatening this if I take here, and I can't even go here to, you know, make it so it's not a pin, because this is a checkmate. I mean, that's pretty brutal, so I think I resigned there. Yeah, it was just a bad game. I almost didn't really feel like looking at it on stream, because I didn't think it was that interesting, just because I just played so badly. But then I felt like I would hear, like, why don't you ever look at the games that Daniel wins? So I decided to do it. So there you go. I don't think it was very interesting, though. But just so, you know, it doesn't seem like I'm only showing games where I win. I don't find it interesting when I lose.